Good morning to everyone. It's a great occasion for us and also a very unusual situation. We are going to celebrate our 24th Foundation Day celebration. During this occasion, I would like to appreciate all the team members, associates, leaders for their intensive and active engagement in addressing COVID-19 issue. All of you are now involved in ensuring the health security and also in livelihood revival process. Every day we are interacting with all our members and making their life better. During this occasion of October 2nd, you have to remember Gandhi. He said that we are really working with the community for a Swaraj. So community themselves are managing this process so actively and very interestingly. So here I would like to present a few thoughts. My focus of talk is next practices in Daan Collective. So what is this next practices in Daan Collective? We are now having a mutual nested federation collectives. All of us have our mother federation. Now we are talking about Jeevitham Federation, Mutual Federation Collective, and Sugam Federation Collective, and also other cross-cutting team collective. So likewise, we have a layers of institution as a collective at a grassroots level. So this is going to be a very interesting year to lay the foundation for Nested Mutual Federation Collective. This is going to be a very important activity for us. Not only that, we are also going to work on the community financing, the aspect. What is it, the community financing? How is it relevant for us? And also advancing the community financing. So the community financing is not only brings viability and sustainability, it also helps in self-growth of new groups or new clusters or new federation, and it also helps in mutuality of helping other federation in the north or who are really facing difficulties. So this community financing made us to stable even during this pandemic time. The self-sustainability and the cost coverage was our founding principle in the entire organization. The third area which I am really going to talk about is basically we need to really go for a creative financing during this period, difficult time. What is creative financing? Some of the funding internally done, and we have to now look for local philanthropist. At least 5 to 10 lakh rupees from each region would be involved in mobilizing significant individuals and to bring them. And also we should work with bank insurance companies for their COVID response loans. And not only that, government departments. We have a livelihood entitlements from agriculture departments and other donors. So this creative financing is going to take us to the next level. For this, we need adaptive human resources. So for this pandemic, there are our leadership is really getting expressed. Many of the program leaders are actively engaged in different regions to bring the livelihood revival into that process. We are also now looking for, after this pandemic COVID, our S1, S2, S3, the survival and also the kind of other categories with the family categories, we are little bit gone back during pandemic time. So we need to revive those and also advance that. That is going to be our very, very important aspect for us. Usually we do a moving out of poverty. Now this time our moving out of poverty is also going to be there, and also retrieving the people who are really gone back and to bring them is also going to be a big challenge for us. Women empowerment is going very strongly. Our leadership played a critical role in this situation, and also they are bringing a theory of change of women empowerment and very actively. This year we are retrieving the commons, encroachment eviction. So many of our institutions are getting involved in encroachment eviction in waterways, water bodies and roads, and also common lands and forest lands. so that commons are very, very important for future generation. So we have to keep our common lands intact and use it for our good purposes. We also had a very interesting for the COVID response in 4 stages. Now we are in adaptation phase. That's going well. And this year we are having 3 new launches. Health program, virtual wellness center, and there also the new hospital is coming there. And in addition to that, the kind of the Sugam Institute of Health Science is also coming with a training situation. That is our health launch. The second launch is Model Panchayat. That is our very important. In the Model Panchayat, 35 Panchayat, the model villages have been selected for launching this Model Panchayat, and from Panchayat Development Foundation, which is going to lay a foundation for local management in a better way of situation. Then we are also awarding and honoring Dr. Vedachalam, who is a kind of archaeologist and did lot of 30 years of his excellent work, or not 30 plus years, and he is involved in our heritage walk. Now virtual heritage walk is going very, very interestingly. So we are feel proud in honoring Dr. Vedachalam during his foundation day. And 3 awards are going to the deserving person. For Vayalagam Award is going to Velachami, and our Kalanjam Award for a lady from Maharashtra who is really supporting a lot of orphanages, and an institution from Point Kalimar area where they really fight against the farm aquaculture, and also they were really supporting the bird sanctuary. So this is a very, very, very model village. They are also getting a this thing. At this point in time, I would like to acknowledge all our stakeholders, government, and for their entitlement things. And during this pandemic, nearly 70 to 100 crores of entitlement was reached to all our members from different regions and location. And this was due to our associates, our leaders, our staff, and also the members also actively involved in sharing that. And our special gratitude goes to all our supporters, bankers, insurance companies, and also our donor institution. We would like to make our special gratitude and also thanks to this. I wish you all for this 25th Foundation Day a great success. Thank you.